Hey guys, today I want to read a couple of answers from Team Lolirock. I'm sorry if I read it somehow though, I'm just had a headache. And this is the reason why the video wasn't being released for so long. Well, let's get started. I show my friend Lolirock and he has a question that I can't answer. Why the band named Lolirock as a pinon lollipop, as in candy? I'm not for sure, but I don't think so. If I recall correctly, we moved from lollipop to Lolirock because lollipop was too close to lollipop, even thought the musical style of the princess is close to pop, that rock. Now changing the name while joining to a project Happiness Often. Before Lollipop Lolirock, we were supposed to be pretty poor, but it was too close to pretty cure. And even before that we should have been Star Princess, but couldn't give this name. And at the very, very beginning in Twice Ice Angels, it was back in an early development of the project, when the girls were supposed to ice skate and start of singing. See, lots of training and evolution before coming to Lolirock. They fit in runic symbols. Hi Lolirock fans, it was requested to release the fitting symbols we use in the show for backgrounds, book spells, etc. Does it have a meaning? Well, no. It is not a real alphabet when thought there in 26 symbols. To be honest, we thought of adding messages, but there was such the rush to produce the show that we didn't make it in the end. The symbols were created by Jace Lothan when this talk himself, and his main references was the Scandinavian runic alphabet. I have been asked a lot of things regarding the spell and magic system in Single Sun. Important point, take more about the future posts. The elements in Lolirock? It is just an observation, but I think the princess represents the four classic elements. Ariana related to moon and stars, with the light breathes can elude fire. Talia, her symbol is the diamond and her theme is blue, so she can't represent water. Lina, she uses levitation and flame. Tells me right or the bad that she might represent air. Carissa uses magic when in direct contact with her first. She used hand-to-hand combat with magic and is in crushing huge rocks with her powers, so she can be Earth. Ares is the first element, Queen Ares, keeping to united all four elements and provide life. There are very many manifestations of energy. Another interesting note is that somehow for Sailor Moon, but not exactly. The blue Sailor Mercury and red Sailor Mars comes to aid the princess Sailor Moon in the first few episodes, when they were soon joined by a green one. Sailor Jupiter and the last member this time Valent. This is just an observation. Heck, in Lolirock continues to rock our road, we might as well get 10 princes. Hey, that is a very interesting theory. Truth is, Jean loses when this talk indeed thought of the HQ as an element, quite like you described above. Except that Iris would be referred as light holy elements, as opposed to Grammar's dark element. But it's not all. When thinking of the princess, his other reference was chess. Now's Princess doesn't correspond to each piece, but it was more a specifical reference. In jazz, each piece have its skills and specific use. The kinds can do same things as a tower, etc. Yeah, you need to use properly all the pieces to win the game. He wanted the princes to complete each other this way. As imagine, we have specialists to our princes at the start of the show. Ariana and the Walton people in the best when it comes to defense means very strong shields. Dallas and the Harris people is the attack station and use celebr skill to drag the opponent rather than pure. Iris, the princess of Ophidia, and like other Ophidian's people, is it on the other hand more offensive and powerful than any other princess, but somehow lack control and needed to learn a lot of skills. She need help from the others. Now it's not really always a vision in the show, and clearly depends on the episodes. But having a team was Jean Lotus' intention. Basically, the Hellcow is latched to the magic. All magical long, like Fidea, magic is everywhere within the air. That's why people that have different colors than on Earth. However, on Earth, a place without magic, in the magical colors, quickly fade away. Ariana's colors dust from bright orange to red, and Talia's colors darker, from light blue to brown. As for Iris, as a baby, her hair is blonde because he's just a baby, but if she had a gown of Fidea, no doubt they would have because pink very quickly. So yeah. You can image baby Talia with brown colored hair and baby Ariana with red colored hair. When princess transform, is both their magic and power, as explained in the first episode. The magic strong enough to alter the color of the hair. Now during the events of home final season, all princess magical jewels are broken, meaning they can't transform on you the most powerful spells. The magic power is several discrete, however it only blocks their transformation. If any of your princess were to stay long enough on the feed, their hair color it gradually switch to the magical one. The healing however, would remain the same, as only the transformation make the grow. Now, let's be honest about the order we proceed. We wanted a color change for our characters from casual to magical. That was beginning, everything above was watching, everybody mostly at the same time as we storyboard the series episode. We ask it ourselves, how do we proceed? Talia will be a kid, but she will be on Fidea. Shall we give her brown or her blue hair? And I hope we see you soon in this channel. I don't say goodbye, see you soon!